I am Yoti. I'm a lawyer and a DJ. I'm also an art critic, and I do a lot of work for the human rights. And I've been brought out here by the Auckland Fringe Festival to host the après-ski show.
And hello, I am Handsome, and we are here to do après-ski, which is something that we love to do.
You know, we come here for the natural lifestyle. And the people, of course. Although, have you noticed the halitosis?
Yes, we have noticed there's a significant level of halitosis in all Kiwis so far, from the plane to the airport, now to here now, and we notice you have quite significant halitosis.
First we think, wow, what is this wretched smell? And when we meet the customs official, it becomes quite clear it is the breath.
It is very clear to us that there is a significant halitosis pandemic across New Zealand so far.
Yeah, this is crisis. Where does one to see the Maoris? Are they around here, or do we need to go to a more heavily wooded area?
No, they're around. They're sort of just this here.
Do they come out at night, or is it?
No, they're not nocturnal as such. I mean, no, they're just here like everyone else, really.
Okay,
so if we want to see one, we simply go and hide round a corner by some bushes and hope that they come out.
And what is this big phallic one here? Because you see, I am a human rights lawyer, and I would like to talk to some of them about the case. Because I understand they have something in writing that they can.
Yes, you have a contract with the colonials, and this contract has been a little bit too complex to understand, and that we thought perhaps we could talk to some Maoris, see if they've signed it and how we can help them to get. Well, do most Maoris still have ownership of the goods that they signed for?
Well, so
let us now go to the Queer Bar in Auckland City to prepare to do our show.
Queen Street, yeah, let's go.
Great.
Okay, someone has been fucking with my case. So this is the queue bar, the queer bar that we're telling you about earlier, where we will be doing the show. These are the three key things that you must have in your fight against the halitosis, along with your toothbrush. You have the dental floss, you have the tongue scraper, and of course the Listerine. This is just your backup, your last line, really. If you scrape your tongue, then you really should have no problem at all.
If you want to keep this Listerine, you may have this, and of course we have more.
Yeah,
so
we
no
have
problem.
Plenty. You can keep this. Yeah. I think you can use this. Yeah. This is the first thing we learn in Sweden about the dental hygiene. It is not something you do for yourself so much as you do for the other people.
The Treaty of Waitangi. Did you sign this treaty?
I did not, no.
You
know.
Sure. Are you a Maori?
I'm a Brazilian.
Oh, a Brazilian?
So you have not signed the contract?
So okay. You are like us, we cannot sign the contract.
No. So yeah, we have to wait a little while, kind of maybe 5 years.
And oh, really?
Will you write or will you use the, will you do the tongue?
No, you do does the right, just if you go to the jail.
Have you signed the treaty?
No.
Oh, this makes it a little more difficult, I think, but maybe there is still, we have some avenues.
It does less, if your case would be a little bit weakened for the fact you haven't signed any particular contract or treaties. This is important if you have issues. Why don't you call Yoti this evening? We see you during the show. And you can bring the treaty with you, and we will look at it and see if there is something.
And we can have a look and see if there's something that we can look for you.
It's just lovely to meet you all, and this is such a beautiful gay bar to be working in.
Yeah, the Q bar. It's cool.
Mm. We will see you tonight.
Yeah, see you tonight.
Great. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3.
I think the mic is on, Hans.
Oh, it is totally on tonight. You are the dancing.